I've done this just for the fame. I can't look at you today. Beverly Knight and Sharon Rose with You've Changed from Sylvia, and you can see the show at the Old Vic until April the 8th. That is it for EPOS this week. Stick around for Johnny Walker because he's not changed. He's up next with Sounds of the 70s. And then this evening from 8, you can hear more fabulous piano room performances from artists including Jesse Ware, Suede and Jake Shears. My thanks to my producer, Jessica Rickson, and I will see you next Sunday at 1 with more of your favourite show tunes and movie songs, more stage and screen news, another onstage mishap, and of course my diva double. Another week begins. Have a fun one. I'm Elaine Page, and this is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker, and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 3 o'clock. This is Catherine Cracknell. Search and rescue teams are continuing to look for survivors of a boat carrying migrants which sank off the southern coast of Italy, killing at least 40 people. Bodies have been recovered from a nearby beach in Calabria, which is littered with the driftwood remains of the vessel. Our correspondent Danny Eberhardt has more details.
Well, we know that about 80 people have survived, according to the Italian Coast Guard. There's pictures of people who were sitting on the edge of the beach, wrapped in blankets and being attended to by Red Cross workers. About 20 people have been taken to hospital, we presume with things like hypothermia. We don't know some really crucial information, one of which is how many people were on the boat when it broke up. It broke up in the hours just before dawn.
The government's hinted politicians in Northern Ireland could be given new powers as part of a fresh deal on post-Brexit trading arrangements. The Deputy Prime Minister Dominic Raab said the UK was on the cusp of securing a new settlement with Brussels. A former Environment Secretary has warned shortages of some fruits and vegetables could last 3 to 4 weeks. George Eustace blamed what he described as a cocktail of weather events in southern Europe and Morocco and said there was nothing much the government could have done.
We're going to have 3 or 4 weeks of this, and the supermarkets have got to work to get it right. But longer term, look, there are things we should be doing. We should be committing to onshore production. So glasshouse production of cucumbers and tomatoes, we should be trying to build that here. We should have a more enlightened approach to labour, so that food can get access to labour.
Nigerians are voting at polling stations in some parts of the country where they were unable to cast their ballots yesterday because of technical problems. Elsewhere, counting is continuing with the first results from the hotly contested presidential election expected later. Our correspondent Peter Okwoche is in Abuja.
They did go rather peacefully in most of the country, but there were pockets of violence in Lagos, in Bayelsa State, which is in the oil-producing Niger Delta. But we've just heard from the head of the Electoral Commission here in Nigeria, Mahmoud Yakubu. He acknowledged that there were some problems, but said counting has begun, and hopefully by tomorrow or early Tuesday, we should begin to get an idea of who the next president of Nigeria is.
Police in Derby have arrested a 14-year-old boy in connection with an incident involving a car which crashed into a house in the early hours of yesterday morning. The boy is accused of aggravated vehicle taking, driving without a license, and driving without